In this tutorial, I will demonstrate how to install and configure the open source LoRaWAN network server called LoRa Server. The LoRa Server project provides open source components for building LoRaWAN networks. The author of this project is Orne Brokar. He started the project end 2015 as a side project, and the project has grown significantly thanks to sponsoring. The LoRa Server project consists of four major components: LoRa Gateway Bridge, LoRa Server, LoRa App Server, and LoRa Geo Server. The LoRa Geo Server will not be discussed in this tutorial. All components are licensed under the MIT license and can be used for commercial purposes. The LoRa Gateway Bridge, this component, abstracts the packet forwarder UDP protocol data into JSON and sends it to the LoRa Server over MQTT, as you can see over here. By the way, to simplify my drawings, I just write the word MQTT broker over here. It means LoRa Gateway Bridge publishes data to the MQTT broker, and the LoRa Server subscribes to topics on this MQTT broker. The LoRa Server, this component, is the LoRaWAN network server. It deduplicates and handles the received uplink frames from the gateway or gateways, handles the LoRaWAN MAC layer, and schedules the downlink data transmissions. The LoRa App Server, this component, is the LoRaWAN application server and handles the join requests, encryptions of application payloads, and offers a RESTful JSON API, gRPC API, or MQTT for external services. The LoRa App Server has a web interface to manage users, organizations, applications, and devices. It also allows you to see the received sensor data. This is the web interface, and you can see the received sensor data over here. So the endnode sends sensor data to the gateway. The gateway sends data to the LoRa Gateway Bridge. The LoRa Gateway Bridge publishes data to the MQTT broker. The LoRa Server receives data from the MQTT broker and sends the data to the LoRa App Server. The user can see the sensor data in the web interface. Many users are sending their sensor data to the Things network. Now you can create your own private LoRaWAN network by using the LoRa Server components. More information about the LoRa Server project, see this link. All LoRa Server project code can be found at this link. If you have questions, go to the LoRa Server forum. See this link. The LoRa Server and the LoRa App Server each requires their own PostgreSQL database. There are many configurations of these components possible. For example, all LoRa Server components and their dependencies can be installed on their own servers. The LoRa Gateway Bridge is installed on its own server. The LoRa Server is installed on its own server. And the LoRa App Server is installed on its own server. Here is another configuration. All LoRa Server components and their dependencies can be installed on the gateway itself, which I will demonstrate in this video. So the LoRa Gateway Bridge, LoRa Server, and LoRa App Server and their dependency are installed on the gateway itself. Again, here's another configuration. All LoRa Server components and their dependencies can be installed on a single server instance, as you can see over here. And again, here's another configuration. The LoRa Gateway Bridge can be installed on the gateway itself, as you can see over here. The other LoRa Server components and their dependencies can be installed on the single server instance, as you can see over here. By the way, the MQTT broker can be installed on this server, or it can be installed on a separate server. This is a nice LoRa Server architecture drawing. Here you can see the most common used configurations. If you have a single gateway, the LoRa Gateway Bridge is installed on the gateway. All the other components are installed on the same server instance or on separate servers. If you have more than one gateway, the LoRa Gateway Bridge is installed together with the other components on the same server instance or on separate servers. The gateway has the Semtech packet forwarder installed. The global configuration.json and the local configuration.json files are used to configure the packet forwarder. In the global configuration.json file, the LoRa Gateway Bridge server address and port are set, as you can see over here. Here you set the LoRa Gateway Bridge server address, and these are its ports. The packet forwarder has now all the information it needs to send data to the LoRa Gateway Bridge. In this example, the LoRa Gateway Bridge is installed on the gateway because of the word localhost. The LoRa Gateway Bridge abstracts the received packet forwarder UDP protocol data. The data is converted into JSON and published to a MQTT broker, as you can see over here. The LoRa Gateway Bridge TOML file is used to configure the LoRa Gateway Bridge. As you can see over here, this is the MQTT broker address and port, and in this example, the MQTT authentication is not set. In this example, the MQTT broker and LoRa Gateway Bridge are installed on the same server because of this IP address. The LoRa server is the LoRaWAN network server, and it has a PostgreSQL database to store the gateway data, as you can see over here. The LoRa server TOML file is used to configure the LoRa server. Here's an example of such a file. This is the PostgreSQL data source name. This is the username and this is the password. This is the database hostname or server address. And this is the database name. And as you can see, SSL is not used. In this configuration file, this LoRaWAN regional band is used. In the LoRa server TOML file, you can find other LoRaWAN regional band values. This is the MQTT broker address and port. The MQTT authentication is not set. And the system local time zone is used. In this example, the MQTT broker, PostgreSQL database, and LoRa server are installed on the same server. This is because of the word localhost used here and here. The LoRa App Server is the LoRaWAN application server, and it also has a PostgreSQL database to store the gateway data, as you can see over here. The LoRa server communicates with the LoRa App Server through an internal API server, listening on port 8001. You can receive and send data to endnodes using gRPC APIs or RESTful JSON APIs, or you can use MQTT. There's also a web server listening on port 8000, which communicates with the LoRa App Server. The LoRa App Server TOML file is used to configure the LoRa App Server. Here are a few settings in the LoRa App Server TOML file. Again, this is the Postgres data source name. This is the username. Please note, the username in this example ends with _AS. This is the database password. This is the database hostname. And this is the database name. In this example, the database name ends with _AS. SSL is not used, as you can see. This is the MQTT broker address and port. MQTT authentication is not set. And this is the internal API server address and port. The LoRa server, the LoRa app server, and the MQTT broker are installed on the same server. This is because of the use of the word localhost here and here. So this was a short and simplified explanation how the LoRa server components works. The components have more configuration parameters which you can set. For more information, read the documentation. See this link. I have created a manual how to install and configure the LoRa Gateway Bridge, LoRa Server, LoRa App Server and their dependencies on the REC 831 Pilot Gateway. You can find this manual at this link. So here you can see how to install the LoRa Gateway Bridge, LoRa Server, LoRa App Server, how to modify the LoRa Gateway Bridge configuration, how to modify the packet forwarder configuration, check if all required services are running, how to use the LoRa App Server web interface, how to modify and upload a sketch to the EndNote, how to check if sensor data is displayed in the LoRa App Server web interface, and finally, if you have errors, how to check the LoRa Gateway Bridge, LoRa Server, and LoRa App Server for errors. Now I will demonstrate how to install the LoRa Gateway Bridge, LoRa Server, and LoRa App Server and their dependencies on the same gateway. I am following the same steps as described in my user manual. On the gateway, I will install the LoRa Gateway Bridge. But first, I need to upgrade the Raspberry Pi packages. Install Mosquito, enter this command. The LoRa Server project provides pre-compiled binaries packaged as Debian packages. In order to activate this repository, execute the following commands. Enter the following command. And enter this command. And enter this command. Now install the LoRa Gateway Bridge. Start the LoRa Gateway Bridge. By the way, I'm using this command instead of this command. Raspbian uses systemd instead of initd. Now verify if the LoRa Gateway Bridge is running and check if there are no errors. Enter this command. As you can see, active running and there are no errors. Let's check the log file. Enter this command. As you can see, there are no errors. Enter this command to start LoRa Gateway Bridge on boot. I will now install the LoRa Server. In this tutorial, the LoRa Server will also be installed on the gateway. First, install PostgreSQL. Next, install Redis Server. LoRa Server needs its own database. To create a new database, start the PostgreSQL prompt as Postgres user. Enter this command. Within the PostgreSQL prompt, enter the following queries. These queries. Enter the first query. And enter the second query. The database is called LoRaServer_NS. And quit. To verify if the user and database have been set up correctly, try to connect to it. Enter this command. Password is dbpassword. And as you can see, I am connected to the database. Now quit. Install LoRaServer. Enter this command. Modify the LoRaServer configuration file. This configuration file. First, switch to root. Go to this folder. Open the file with an editor. Search for DSN. And save the file. In the configuration file, these parameters have these default values. Change these parameters if needed. In this tutorial, I am keeping the default values. When you are done making changes, enter the exit command. Start a LoRaServer. Verify if the LoRaServer is running. As you can see, LoRaServer is running. Enter this command to start LoRaServer on boot. Now let's install LoRa App Server. The LoRa App Server will also be installed on the gateway. The LoRa App Server persists the gateway data into a PostgreSQL database. LoRa App Server needs its own database. To create a new database, start the Postgres prompt as the Postgres user. Enter this command. Within the Postgres prompt, enter the following queries. This is the first query. And this is the second query. The database created is called LoRaServer_AS. And quit. That is wrong. You must not quit yet. Again, start the PostgreSQL prompt as the Postgres user. Enable the Trigram extension. Enter this command. Next, enter this command. And now you can quit. Now verify if the user and database have been set up correctly. Try to connect to it. Enter this command. The password is dbpassword. And as you can see, I am connected to the database. Quit. Install LoRa App Server. Enter this command. Now create a JSON web token. Enter this command. Copy this token. You will need it at the next step, but keep this token secret. I will paste the token here. Now let's modify the LoRa App Server configuration file, this configuration file. Let's switch to root. Go to this folder. Open the file with an editor. Search for DSN. Change this value to this value. Now search for this parameter, JWT_secret. Copy the token. And now save the file. And now enter the command exit. Start the LoRa App Server. Enter this command. Verify if the LoRa App Server is running. Enter this command. As you can see, the LoRa App Server is running. Start LoRa App Server on boot. Enter this command. Now let's modify the LoRa Gateway Bridge configuration. The LoRa Gateway Bridge configuration file is located at this folder, and we need to make this change. But this is already the default value. The LoRa Gateway Bridge and the other components will be installed on the same gateway. And by default, all configuration files use a server addresses 127.0.0.1 or localhost. This means we don't need to modify the LoRa Gateway Bridge configuration file at all. So let's skip this step. Let's modify the packet forwarder globalconfiguration.json file. Go to this folder and open the globalconfiguration.json file with an editor. Go to the end of the file. This is our current server address. Let's comment it out. This is the server address and ports of the LoRa Gateway Bridge. Save this file and exit this file. Now let's reboot the gateway. Enter this command. After the gateway is rebooted, log into the gateway. Now let's check if all required services are running. Let's check the gateway itself. Enter this command. As you can see, the gateway is up and running. Now let's check the MQTT broker. And the MQTT broker is also up and running. Let's check the LoRa Gateway Bridge. And the LoRa Gateway Bridge is also up and running. Let's check the LoRa server. The LoRa server is also up and running. And finally, check the LoRa App Server. And the LoRa App Server is also up and running. Open a web browser and enter the IP address where the LoRa App Server is installed, followed by port 8080. The LoRa App Server is installed on the gateway. So I have entered the IP address of my gateway, followed by port 8080. Enter the username admin, and the password is admin. Login. I have already done all the steps mentioned in my user manual, so I will go through these steps again. Select network servers. Press the Add button. Enter a network server name, LoRa Server 1. Enter the hostname and port of the network server. Enter localhost 8000. Select tab Gateway Discovery. Do not check this box. And then press the button Add Network Server. After you have done this, it looks like this. Next, select Gateway Profiles. Do not create gateway profiles. Select Organizations. By default, the organization LoRa Server is created. Select it and modify the organization name and display name. I have modified it to MobileFish and display name is MobileFish Research and Development. And check this box. Press the button Update Organization. After you have made the modifications, it looks like this. Make sure your organization is shown here. Select Server Profiles. Press the Create button. Enter a server's profile name. Select the network server. That's the network server you just created before. Select it. Check this box. Add gateway metadata. The minimum allowed data rate is set to 0. And the maximum allowed data rate is set to 5. These two values apply for the European Union. Press the button Create Service Profile. When you have done this, you will see this. Select Device Profiles. Press the Create button. Enter a device profile name. For example, this is my device profile name. Select the network server. That is the network server you created before. Select the LoRaWAN MAC version, that is 1.0.2. This is the LoRaWAN MAC version supported by the device. I will use the Arduino LMIC library when I upload my sketch. The Arduino LMIC library supports LoRaWAN MAC version 1.0.2 revision A. Select the LoRaWAN regional parameters revision, that is A. And don't change the max AIRP value. Select tab Join OTA ABP. Check this box, device supports OTA. My endnode will use over-the-air activation and not ABP. I have not checked this box. I'm only interested in class A. Select tab Class C. I have not checked this box. I'm only interested in class A. Then press this button, Create Device Profile. After you have created your device profile, you will see this. Select Gateways. Press the Create button. Enter a gateway name. This is my gateway name. Enter a gateway description. This is my gateway description. And enter your gateway ID. That is the same gateway ID you can find in the local configuration.json file. This is my gateway ID. Select the network server. That is the network server you created before. We have not created a gateway profile, so we can skip this. I am not using gateway discovery, so this checkbox is not checked. My gateway is located 10 meters above ground. Now drag the marker to the location of the gateway. When you are done, press the button Create Gateway. After you created your gateway, you will see this. Select Applications. Press the Create button. Enter an application name. And enter an application description. Select your server's profile. That's this one I've created before. You can enter a payload codec. By defining a payload codec, LoRa App Server can encode and decode the binary device payload for you. And that is what I want. I select Custom JavaScript Codec Functions. Let's go to my manual. And this is my decode function. I've pasted my decode function in this text area. I'm not using an encode function. Press the Create Application button. When you are done, you will see this. Select your application and press the Create button. Now you can enter your device name and a device description. This is my device name and device description. So now you need to generate a device AUI. I will upload this Arduino sketch to my EndNote. And it needs a device AUI. And as you can see, it must be in little endian format. Change this to LSB. And then press this button. It will generate a random device AUI. Copy this and save this. You will need it later. Now select the device profile you created before. That is this one. And check this box. I am disabling the frame counter. Please note, by disabling the frame counter, validation will compromise security as it enables people to perform replay attacks. Press this button, Create Device. After you have created your device, select Applications, select your application, and your device AUI will be shown. Select your device and select keys and press this button. Here you can generate an application key. Let's get back to my Arduino sketch. That is this application key. As you can see, the key must be in big endian format. So select MSB. And press this button to generate the key. Then copy this key. You will need it later. Then press the button Set Device Keys. Let's assume this is your generated dev AUI in little endian format, and this is your generated app key in big endian format. You need to convert these generated values into this format. Just prefix each hex value with 0x and separate each value by a comma, as you can see over here. Do the same for the app key. Once you have done this, open the Arduino sketch and enter the values. For example, this is a dev AUI, that is this value. Paste it in here and do the same for the app key. That is this value. You see the value app AUI. The key app AUI is not used by LoRa server. So you can enter any value. I have entered this value. Now your sketch is modified and can be uploaded to your end device. My gateway is up and running. My end device transmits sensor data to the gateway. Now let's check it. Now let's log into the LoRa App Server web interface. Enter username admin and password admin. Press the login button. Select gateways. And select RED831. So last seen shows a few seconds ago. That is good. Now select Applications, select Application App B, select Test Device 1, select Live LoRaWAN Frames. I am receiving LoRaWAN Frames I will now reset my end device. I have reset my end device. And as you can see, there is a join request and a join accept. Now select live device data. And as you can see, it receives humidity and temperature data. This data is created by the JavaScript decode function. In my Arduino sketch, I have specified that every 30 seconds, a sensor data is transmitted. Let's again select gateways, select RAC831, and you can see the frames received and the frames transmitted. In your web browser, after the hostname and port number, enter /API and press enter. And here you can find the LoRa App Server REST APIs. To use the LoRa App Server REST API, you need to enter your JSON Web Token in this field. More information about the uses of the LoRa App Server APIs, see this link. In a future tutorial, I will explain how to use these REST APIs. Go back and log out. This is the LoRa server website, and you can also find this option, LoRa Gateway OS. The LoRa Gateway OS is an easy way to get started with LoRaWAN and the LoRa server project. LoRa Gateway OS are SD card images which contains out-of-the-box support for the Semtech Packet Forwarder, LoRa Gateway Bridge, LoRa Server, and LoRa App Server for certain concentrator shields. More information can be found at the page I have just shown you. There are a number of concentrator shields which uses the Raspberry Pi 3. For these concentrator shields, two different SD card images are available. The image LoRa Gateway OS Base and the image LoRa Gateway OS Full. This image only contains the Semtech Packet Forwarder and the LoRa Gateway Bridge. If you use this image, it has out-of-the-box support for Semtech Packet Forwarder, LoRa Gateway Bridge, LoRa Server, and LoRa App Server. There are also gateways on the market with the LoRa Server components already installed, such as the RAC WIS kit. This kit contains, among other things, the RAC 2245 Pi Head, which is the LoRa concentrator module, the Raspberry Pi 3B Plus, and the WIS node, which is a LoRa node. A tutorial about this can be found at this location. Please note the following. An SD card may wear out. The lifetime of SD cards is limited by the number of writes. It is recommended not to use cheap SD cards. LoRa Server tries to minimize the number of database writes. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe. If you have questions, leave your comments below. I'll do my best to answer them.